means I don't need it. I really don't. I don't. Pretty darn loud. Every day I get on my grind, praying that life won't leave me behind. God knows that I'm dying to go on home, on home. City lights are blurring my eyes. For this love, I'm paying the price. God knows that I'm trying to go on home, on home. Question. How do we profit from what we love to do most? Me, well, I feel like I'm sneaking through a cemetery searching for my own ghost, or trying to dig through sedimentary rock buried beneath the heap of my life's compost. I feel like a scared soldier that went AWOL from the military, abandoning her post. Contrary to what I always dreamed I would be, like a victim of my own negligence, running from me, standing amongst a host of like-minded individuals struggling for originality, puzzling such a complex simplicity, so I end each day disastrously, knowing, thinking there has got to be more, but eventually takes too long to get to, 5 steps from too far away, and I personally have no patience waiting on that destination. But you say that there is a predetermination factor, and you say that life is a stage and that we are all actors. Well, damn. I must have forgotten my lines, or left my script behind in my mama's womb, because my vision looks blurry, but I can see the writing on the stone of my tomb. And I don't want to be doomed here in the limbo of complacency, blatantly out of place, deliberately keeping a monotonous pace, inadvertently going to waste, or pasted to the monetary codependency of the next check. Like my boy Justin once told me, living my life in retrospect, I want to learn. Protect my best assets, but always bid high when I bet. Set my eyes on the prize and rise like the opposite of sunsets. Look back having no regret. Consolidate my pain like debt so I can hone all of my energy into overcoming. Select my weaknesses to be my strengths and always represent what you see in the fine print. Because I've spent too many times trying to turn nickels and dimes into dollars, but I was always just making sense. So now I'm trying to maximize my day minutes in life like I was calling my friends and family members Sprint to Sprint or T-Mobile. Because you see, this life's journey is long distance, and walking briskly is too risky. I've got to set my feet to move faster because there is so much in life that I am after. I'm looking for that technicolor finish line with the pot of gold, but I don't want to end this chapter the way it begun. So though I am young, I succumb to my sentences and songs, write on, then stay up all night memorizing my rhyme, hit the road, then call in sick to my job, burden up all my vacation, holiday, personal leave, and sick time. Yeah. I know my day is coming, but I'm still waiting in line. Hoping that my card won't be declined. I never expected to have anything handed to me, so I will earn mine. Because on the road to success, there's no such thing as exit signs, and I'm only defined by my limitations. I will not accept any imitation. The key to staying ahead in this poetry game is all about innovation. So yeah, I'll accept any invitation to fill the open slots. And if the slam is full, that's cool. I just rock the open mic spot. My talent and my passion is all I've got. And when I step off stage, I accept cash, personal check. But if not, tell me that my words touched your soul, because that statement is worth more than you will ever know. Worth its own personal weight and gold. Answer to the question that I posed about 3 or 4 minutes ago. We as poets profit from the value of our words. May yours and yours and yours hold virtue. Woo!